everybody, and welcome to Peculiar Journeys with Pastor Jael. I'm Pastor Jael. This is my peculiar journey, and today I'm going to read you a story. It's true, I am. Story that is brought to you by this cool shirt I'm wearing. It is a HVLC Higher Vision Leadership College preview day. So I'm like, I will wear my shirt to support the students. And it says, for such, I know how to look at it. What does it say? It says, for such a time as this. And that comes from Esther chapter 4, verse 14, where Esther's cousin Mordecai was like, maybe you were here for such a time as this, for a reason. Right, my friend Christine, who's on, she waved at me. Okay, so Tony, I'm gonna read you a story brought to you by the Beginner's Bible. What? Published by Zondervan Company, publishing company. The Brave Queen, let's read together. Okay, Esther was Jewish. True. That means she was an Israelite. She lived in the land of Persia with her older cousin, Mordecai. Sue is an older cousin, man. Okay, that's him. Mordecai. Okay, next page. The king of Persia needed a new queen. He announced, bring me the most beautiful women from all over my kingdom. That's how I'm pretending he spoke. Okay. Esther was one of the women sent to the palace. When the king met Esther, he chose her to be his queen. That's pretty good. Next page. Haman. Ooh, that's the bad guy. Doesn't that just sound like a bad guy name? I think it sounds like a bad guy name. Okay. Haman was the king's chief helper. He hated the Jewish people. They were God's people. Haman wanted everyone to bow down to him. Mordecai refused to bow down to Haman. Mordecai would only bow down to God. Haman, so that's Haman. You look at that. That's like evil right there. Okay. Haman went to the king and he said, the Jews are bad people. You should sign a law that will help me get rid of them. I'm pretending he laughed. He probably laughed. I mean, come on. Like evil, mean laugh. Okay. So the king signed a new law. God's people were in great danger. What are they gonna do? I don't know. Let's turn the page. Okay. Mordecai heard about the new law. He ran to tell Esther, you must save yourself and the rest of God's people. Perhaps God has made you for the queen for this reason. So that's that verse we talked about. That's the verse that matches my shirt, right? That Esther was there for such a time as this. That means for a reason at that time. Let's continue. So Esther came up with a plan. It would be very risky for her. So Esther invited the king. So there's the king and Haman, bad dude Haman. And there's Esther. She's cool. Okay. So invited the king and Haman to a special dinner. Then she asked the king, why does Haman want to get rid of me? The king was surprised. She said, I am Jewish. Haman tricked you into signing a new law that would get rid of all the Jews. The plot thickens. Dun, dun, dun. Oh, man. Okay. The king told his guards, arrest Haman. Then he made Mordecai his new chief helper. And he told Queen Esther, I will make a new law that will keep you and your people safe. God used Esther to save her people. Okay, here's what I'm trying to tell us today. Sometimes we may not like where we're at, right? Maybe, Sophia, maybe you're like, God, why am I in this school? Or maybe sometimes you might think, God, why am I in this family? Let me encourage you with this from Esther 4:14. Maybe you're there for what? For such a time as this, meaning God placed you where you're at on purpose. Just like God placed Esther where she was on purpose, God has placed you where you are on purpose so that you can bring change to your family, you can bring change to your school, you can bring change to your community. Now you might be scared and like, what am I gonna do? I can't do that, right? And sometimes we feel like we can't, but let me tell you something cool. When we surrender to God, we know that we can't on our own, but with God, we can. So let's pray together. Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for your goodness, God. And Lord, thank you that you have called us and placed us where we are, even at this time in history, because you have a plan. And God, I thank you that you are going to use each and every one of us for your glory and for your plan, Lord. And so God, I ask right now, Lord, that your kingdom will come and your will be done on earth here, Lord, as it is in heaven. And so Lord, thank you for calling us to where we are. And we know that we are here for such a time as this. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen, friends. Thank you so much for joining me today on my peculiar journey. And if you want to get your very own copy of The Beginner's Bible by Zondervan, you can go ahead and do that too. It's super fun. I like the pictures. Great animation. Great truths of story. Amen. All right. That's the story, guys. Remember that every day with God is an adventure. So let's live God's adventures together. Have a beautiful day, and I'll see you next time on Peculiar Journeys with Pastor Jael. That's me. Amen. All right, see you later, guys. Bye.